Josecito Lopez retired his last two opponents.
Really?
Yes. She had retired and John Molina retired.
Damn.
What do you think? He's fighting. He may be fighting Sean Porter next.
That's he's on a roll. He has the momentum going, and I'm gonna back Josecito all the way.
You sparred him.
Yeah.
How hard does he hit?
He hits pretty hard.
Everybody says that. What does that mean, Virgil?
Like
what do you mean hits hard compared to like everybody else?
He hits hard.
Harder than 160 pounders?
When he's not trying to hit hard, he's still hitting hard. That he has that power. He doesn't. He doesn't have to throw hard to hit hard.
He's a 147 pounder.
His punches hurt.
They feel like 175.
Yeah.
It's Nano. It's Lua. Hey, Virgil just told me that you hit hard even when you don't try to hit hard. And he says that you hit like a 175 pounder, not 147.
It's like him too.
He hits very hard as well. But people who have been coming to the gym to spar always tell me you hit the hardest. You hit very hard. Why do you hit people so hard? Why are you so mean?
They hit me hard.
No, I'm just kidding. So, Osito, you retired your last two opponents. You may fight Sean Porter. That's a mega fight.
Yeah.
You love it? I'm sure Sean Porter would love it.
Mega fight. Exciting fight, man. I'm all up for exciting fight.
You want to fight the best.
Yep.
And you want to fight for the championship.
Exactly.
And I think he's a mandatory or interim because he just fought against a German dude and won something.
Oh, okay.
His last fight, I'm not sure. It was, yeah. I saw it, but I think he won the interim title. And hopefully the fight happens soon.
Yep.
But you're always in shape. That's one thing about you. You never balloon up.
Yeah.
And like I said, you're looking younger now than you did 2 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
You're happy. You're in a good place.
I'm moisturized.
You're in a good place. You've been pro 19 years, right?
Yeah, half my life, 18.
That's crazy, 18 years. Well, it's been a new year now, so I said 19.
Oh, man.
But half of the guys in the gym, here's Ronnie Rios, he's barely 19 years old. Everybody's here. Like, when they were born, you were a pro fighter already. Do you believe that he's been pro 19 years?
Still looks good, man.
I just told him
that. He still looks good. He actually looks younger now than he did when I first saw
him. I just said that. You see, I'm not lying.
Hey. Fresher, man. He looks fresher.
He retired his last two opponents.
Yeah, no, I saw the last fight against Santana. Santana's a cool dude.
He's a great dude. Shout out to Chia.
He's a good dude.
Ronnie.
Yes, sir.
Josecito Lopez, Sean Porter. Break it down.
That's a good fight. That's a very interesting fight. I feel like if Josecito can put the pressure on, you're kind of, it's kind of hard to say. At first, box early, put the pressure on the later rounds, I think, you know. Everyone has a chance.
What does Joshua need to do to beat Fury?
I don't know. I think, honestly, man, Fury's probably the top heavyweight in my opinion.
I mean, I think it's just a little more experience in Joshua that he's been having, a little more gym work, and a little less amateurish, I guess you can say, and adapt more to the pro style. I think he can win, man. He works hard. That's not,
he's always in
problem.
Shape.
That's
and he punches. He's a big puncher. And in the heavyweight division, one punch could change the whole fight.
Yeah, just to have more of all the natural reactions come out, you know, especially when you get hit, man. You got to hope that all the work you put in comes out naturally. All the instincts just come out naturally.
You fought Keith Thurman, was a great fight.
Yep.
You sparred Virgil. What do you think if they fight? Keith Thurman, Virgil Ortiz.
Virgil's ready for any of the tough guys.
Why?
That's a good fight. I think Virgil's a good fight. Virgil's fighting.
You love that fight? It's a good fight?
Yeah, he's ready for all the top guys now.
He hits very hard, right?
Yeah, he does.
Does he hit like a cruiserweight? Does he hit like a light heavyweight?
Probably a middleweight because he carries the power, but he still has the speed, so more of a middleweight.
He's 147, but he hits like he's 160.
Yeah, oh, easy. Easy, man.
Let's go. Where'd he go? It's Nano. Xavier, you're in the house. Virgil, Josecito gave you a big compliment. He said it's not only the power that you have, but he said you have speed.
Yeah.
He said you're like a 160 pounder in a 147 body.
That's cool.
You know, he might fight Sean Porter.
Yeah, no, that's
exciting. And that's then I asked him,
if you go back to the interviews that you talked about, I said that he should fight either Danny Garcia or Sean Porter. Those are the fights that I said. I'm glad that he's getting that fight with Sean Porter.
Then I asked him about you against Keith Thurman. He fought Keith Thurman. He sparred you. He said you're ready for any of those guys. You're ready. That's a big compliment.
Yeah.
You're only 16 fights in your career. Mm-hmm. Later.
All right.
So what's the plan for today? What's up?
Spar.
What are you gonna do today?
Spar.
Who are you sparring?
Dudes. I think I'm sparring Ruben, and I think I'm sparring another guy. I'm not sure.
So just you're staying busy, staying loose?
Yeah.
If it is Hooker.
Huh?
If it is Maurice Hooker, what can we expect?
Expect a Dallas shootout. It's gonna be a good fight. A lot of people are writing him off. Lot of people think that it's getting to my. No, I'm training for this fight like it's the hardest fight of my life, because it probably is, you know?
He is.
He gave Jose Ramirez a hell of a fight.
Yep.
So, no, we're staying ready for whatever.
It's no.
We don't think any fight is.
You have to respect every opponent, expect the best version.
Oh, yeah.